Welcome to Pion Press channel.
Hello.
Today we are going to do really interesting video. This is our brand new concept and I call this Willet hydraulic video series. And the idea is to test some really stupid hydraulic fluids. For example, today we are going to test bananas and non-Newtonian fluid. And it's really technical thing, the hydraulic system. I have studied myself hydraulics in university, so I know that stuff, but for example Anni had some problems understanding what we are doing today. So I'm going to put it really simple. You have all seen our extruder 5 million, and the idea is to fill this cylinder with something and then push this down and everything comes out of here. And now we are going to add some parts to this setup. First thing is this hose right here. So the stuff isn't coming out, it stays in the hose and it goes through this here, where it goes to this smaller cylinder. And because the piston is up, there isn't any room here for stuff to like be. So it has to push the piston down and the piston starts to move until it hits the coconut. And then there isn't any room to go. And this is still going to push really hard. So the pressure starts to rise here. And the pressure that is rising in here is going to add force to this piston until this coconut breaks. Or then we hit our maximum pressure that the system can take and we cannot add anymore. But because it's a 50 millimeter cylinder, I do some calculations. Yeah, so with 300 bars, this 50 millimeter cylinder is going to produce about 6 tons, which should be enough to crack the coconut. Yeah, and now this is empty. And I'm going to show the difference between pneumatics and hydraulics. With pneumatics you have only air, and air compresses, so if this is really hard, then the air is being crushed, not the coconut. And if the air fails, then we are going to try with the bananas and see how the bananas are much better than air. And here is the pressure meter. I think that it might even not move with the air, because I have quite large volume here. And there might be some small leakage and stuff like that. And it's from 0 to 300 bars, so if we got like 3 bars, you cannot see it there. But let's see. Yeah, nothing. The seals inside of that cylinder are in pretty rough shape because all the misuse that we have been doing. So it also might be that the air leaks around the seals because they are in so bad shape. But I'm quite sure that the bananas will work much better. And now we can test the pressure meter. And now I'm going to open this so we can add some bananas. And now is really interesting part. This is like open and I have to get this out. And if I just press from here, then this is going to fly there. So not very good. So I think I'm going to put it like this. Between those two and be really careful. Watch out, Anni. Yeah. And then some bananas. These are some Czech. Yeah, I think there is enough bananas for like round one.
6 bananas.
Because now when I start crushing, I have still the whole hose full of air. And as we saw, air is really poor, like hydraulic fluid. So we want to get this air out from here. So I'm going to put this together and then we are going to crush until we have some bananas flying out of here. And then we are going to attach it there and probably add more bananas. So now we are going to get the air out from the hose by pushing bananas through them. I think this is going to work really well. Yeah, now the system is ready. We should have enough bananas to fill this cylinder up and crush the coconut. My own prediction is that the coconut will be crushed quite easily. Anni was a bit suspicious about the whole thing. She thinks that the coconut isn't going to break. But write your guess now on the comments. And yeah, I'm going to put the big press on and go a bit farther and go away in case that my small press explodes or something bad will happen. Yeah, but here we go! The coconut almost exploded.
Oh my.
And the bananas were doing all the crushing work. There isn't anything but bananas inside of that. And I think we got some serious pressure also on some point before the coconut exploded. I checked the footage and I think that it was about 80 bars here. So it's about almost a third of this. So the coconut took about 2 tons. Or actually it was already here when it was in the 80 bar region. So there was 2 tons maximum force on against the table. And I think we are going to try with something a bit harder. And I'm going to use the big press to push this down. And then the bananas will go from here to here and push this up, and then we are ready to crush more stuff. Pretty interesting, this seems to be stuck here. I think I have to open that. I'm going to open this and there seems to be some pressure inside of the system because I have some sounds coming. We are going to soon be covered in this banana poo. And with real systems, hydraulic oil leaks are extremely dangerous because usually the machines are on quite long time and the oil is really hot, about maybe 80 degrees Celsius. So if something breaks and the oil splash out and you got some on your skin, you are going to get really bad burns from the oil. But I think our bananas didn't have time to heat up. Yeah. Let's try it again. Yes! Coconut pancake. And then I'm going to put this back and then we are going to push this down with the press. Yeah, and now we have the ultimate challenge for the bananas. Hardest thing that we could found. Nokia 3310. So I'm going to put this here and put the big press on and try to crush Nokia with bananas. I'm quite sure that this is first time when somebody has crushed Nokia 3310 with bananas. But here we go! Yeah! check from the camera what was the maximum pressure and can we add a bit more. So new try, I add bit more pressure for the big press and now the pressure meter on the smaller thing shouldn't leak so much. So we should get a bit more crushing on the Nokia. Nokia wins and the banana press lose. But it was really tight match. Yeah, but I'm really pleased on my stupid hydraulic fuel system. This has great potential. And I think we are going to move to the next fluid of our day, non-Newtonian fluid. And we are going to use not very thick non-Newtonian liquid. We are using about same thickness that we used on our extruding non-Newtonian fluid video with the first try. That like move it on sometimes and on the beginning not so much. So my idea is to see what happens when the this thing moves freely and then it hits something and starts to build pressure. Will the non-Newtonian fluid freeze or will it still move under the pressure or what the hell it will happen? Yeah, we are going to change the fluid and find out. Yeah, and now we are going to change the fluid, so I'm going to get the bananas out. There is quite big chunks over here and even the our like premium banana brand sticker is still here. I have no idea how this fits through that hose. Really interesting. And now we are going to clean all the parts from the bananas and put the non-Newtonian fluid in. And now we have the non-Newtonian fluid here. It's quite soft, but still, it's like it's on. You can still extrude this any stiffer, and it won't move at all. So this is good for us. And
great color.
Yeah, great color. And I'm going to pour this here, and then we are going to let it flow through this, and when it's down, then I'm going to add this and then it will stop the flow. And then we are going to put this here. And with that system we don't get any air here at all messing up with our crushings. So yeah, let's see. Yeah, now we are ready. We are going to crush soda bottle with non-Newtonian fluid. And I think this needs about maybe 1 ton or something like that, the soda bottle. It's surprisingly hard. We have crushed those before. So yeah, let's see. And now we are ready for the last crush of the day. Nokia 3310 vs non-Newtonian fluid press. So yeah, here we go. Yeah, Nokia lose and the non-Newtonian fluid press wins. So pretty good, and I think that the non-Newtonian fluid that we have, it's liquid enough. It moves just like almost like water, and if we add more flower, then it just stops on the one point. And there isn't like any problem with not very thick one like this. Yeah, I think we are ready for today. It was quite hard work.
Yeah, my shirt was white before that project.
Mine is still black, so you picked up the wrong color. And if you like our t-shirts, there is link to our t-shirt shop in description and end screen. We have also some other stuff there. Yeah, but I am very pleased on the like whole concept using weird hydraulic fluids. This was really interesting for me, and I think that this suits our viewers quite well. And there is really lot of stuff that you can do with concepts like this. You can try different fluids. We did only two. Maybe you have some good ideas that we should try inside of this. And then there is also a lot of other like parts and hydraulics than just cylinders. I think we can add some valves, like you can like drive this up and down by using valve and having constant pressure here. And then we can maybe add some like motors. And yeah, there is really lot of different hydraulic parts here. Yeah, and thanks for Salahydro for giving this stuff for free us to be able to make this magnificent hydraulic system. This is really professional. I think this is all for today.
Thank you for watching.
And have a nice day.